Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope that each and every one of you will be fine. So this is the continuation of lecture number 7, and I will be discussing about solar energy in this part of the lecture. So solar energy is the energy from sun. Heat from the sun is used directly by photovoltaic systems, which are known as solar panels, and via solar thermal systems. A solar thermal system works by harnessing the sun's energy and converting it into heat, which is then transferred into your home or other places for heating systems or hot water and space heating. It can also be used by focusing sunlight. I will discuss this later. By focusing sunlight to a point, single point, and then converting the water into steam, or by it can also be used via rotating a Stirling engine. Solar photovoltaic system converts the sunlight directly into electricity. Solar photovoltaic panels are also known as solar cells. They are made up of a semiconductor material, usually silicon, and it captures sunlight and converts the solar radiation into electricity. When the light falls on the semiconductors, the electric field across the junction between the two layers causes the electricity to flow, generating DC current. The benefits of solar panels or solar energy is that the carbon dioxide emissions are zero, and it has minimal environmental effects. But it is said that the carbon footprint of these systems, like solar systems, are not exactly zero, because a lot of carbon is emitted via industries during the manufacturing process of solar cells. There are also limitations to the use of these solar energy systems, like variation in sunlight and low energy density, leading to large space requirements for power production. Moreover, there is also a limitation associated with the solar cells, that when they heat up on the daytime during the sun, due to sun, the energy density tends to reduce. So this is the example of solar dish parabolic thyristors and solar towers. So these are the mirrors, and their focal point is converged to a single point. All of the mirrors have the focal point or their reflection lined toward a single point, and that point gets really, really hot, and we can use that heat energy to run a steam engine or a Stirling engine or whatever else equipment we want. This is the parabolic through collectors. You can see there are tiny pipes like structures raised over the parabolic plate. And when light falls, the parabolic structure converges the sunlight to a single focal point and that tends to heat. Then we can use that focal point to convert water into steam, or use in other appliances. Similarly, this is the example of solar towers, and these are basically the mirrored surfaces, and they are converging the sunlight on a single focal point in order to generate heat energy. Now let us discuss about photovoltaic electricity. Sunlight strikes the solar cell and penetrates to the thick P layer, P for hose or positive region. The electron hole pair is created when the sunlight impacts the energy through the semiconductor atoms in P region. Then the electron move towards one side, while the holes or the positive charge carrier move towards the other side, and the DC current is produced, which can be used to drive loads. Efficiency of commercially available solar cells range from 5 to 15%. In 2017, Pakistan was planning to build largest solar power plant. कायदे आज़म के नाम से था वो, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली ड्यू टू लो एफिशिएंसीज इट डिडंट परफॉर्म वेरी वेल. इन पाकिस्तान वी हैव डिफरेंट वेंडर्स हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग दीज सोलर पैनल्स. होमेज इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ देम. And their price range is from 6,000 to 10,000 rupees per panel. Now I will discuss about the photovoltaic system components. Each cell is capable of generating 1 to 2 watts only. So multiple cells are connected in series and parallel combination to produce more energy. So by connecting more and more solar panel, the surface area is increased. With increase in surface area, the generation capacity of solar panel is increased. Modules connect in groups to form photovoltaic arrays. Tracking systems keep the photovoltaic arrays facing toward the sun and the point where the maximum energy is being collected from the photovoltaic system is called the maximum power point tracking. These are expensive, so most photovoltaic systems have fixed arrays aligned to optimize physical and economic performance. Now I will discuss about the solar power applications. The smallest example of solar power application is the photovoltaic cell that comes in the form of wristwatches and calculators. Medium photovoltaic systems can provide electricity to pump water and communication equipment. They can also be used to supply electricity for a small home or small business. Large arrays supply electricity to thousands of electricity consumers, but large array of photovoltaic systems or solar systems require larger surface areas. Solar power appliances are capable of supplying electricity in locations where power distribution systems do not exist. For example, in remote areas of Kashmir or in Balochistan, they can be used to supply electricity. These are the some examples of solar power generation and their usage. This panel is connected to a water pump and it is collecting water in this hose. The second one, there is a solar panel installed on the rooftop to meet their energy requirements. The third one is the grid connected photovoltaic array. This might be used for commercial purposes, but again, this type of system requires a lot of area.